in South Bend, Indiana, where our pastor is Bishop Thomas H. Willis, Jr., and our overseer is Apostle Paul Brand. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this another day. We thank you, oh God, for another opportunity to come into your house, to give you the glory, honor, and praise that's due unto you, to learn more of your word, God. Lord, and to seek your face, oh God, for more of your power, to live in holiness and righteousness before you all the days of our lives. God, we ask that you bless, oh God, in this service on today. Move by your power and your spirit, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, touch the speaker on today, oh God. Lord, whatever you want to have brought forth, oh God, let it be according to that will, God. In the name of Jesus, touch the hearts of all the listeners, oh God. Give them a heart to receive your word, oh God, and a mind to obey, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, if there be any sick and afflicted on listening to us on today, God, we pray that you would put forth your healing power to heal from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless those that are bereaved on today, oh God. Give them peace and comfort as only you can, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that you would open doors and make ways for your people, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, let your blessings flow, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Save such as should be saved, oh God. Baptize with your precious Holy Ghost, oh God. Pull in the backsliders, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And we'll give you all the glory, honor, and praise for all that you do for us. In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Amen. Amen. I'll read for your hearing Titus 2, 11, and 12. Amen. It says, for the grace of God that hath appeared, that bringeth salvation. I'm sorry. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. Amen. May God add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and obeying of his word. Amen. At this time, we're going to bring forth our pastor, amen, Bishop Thomas H. Willis, Jr. Amen. Let's say amen for him as he comes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank
you. Amen. Give God a victory hand praise. Come on, give him a victory hand praise. Come on, give him the glory. Give him the glory.
Yeah, I know we came to have church, didn't we? Amen. Thank God one more time.
One more time.
One more time. Being in the house of God. Amen. To worship him in spirit. Not in the flesh.
Come on.
But in spirit.
That's right.
And in truth. Amen. As I always say, because God seeketh such. Amen. 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 What a mighty God we serve.
Yes.
What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before
him.
Yes. Heaven and earth adoring.
Yes,
what a mighty God we serve.
Yes.
Amen. We ought to be hollering.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
We ought to be hollering. What a mighty God.
Mighty God.
Amen. Amen. He's a mighty God.
Mighty God.
All he has to do is speak and it comes to exist.
All right now.
Oh, come on with me now. All you have to do is speak to your life, and there will be a change
Amen.
In your life. That's if you want God to change.
Amen. That's right.
You got to want God to change your life. I don't know what's wrong with me. You know, I want to change. But do you really want to change?
Come on, man.
Some people say they want to change. I want to change. I don't like, you know, doing what I'm doing. Amen. But you really, really want to change, you got to go to God.
Yes, yes.
And you got to let God take control.
Yes. Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Drinking alcohol, but me and God.
Come on.
Amen. I had to give God some help.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, y'all better come on that. I mean, he takes the desire away.
Right.
Understand what I'm saying? Come but on. I had to stop drinking.
Right.
So that's what I'm saying. I have to be willing
to
stay away from.
That's right.
Y'all better come on with me now. We're talking about being saved, being sanctified, being changed. Amen. Being a new creature where old things are passed away. And behold, all things become new. Amen. Thank God for being a new creature. I'm not the same. Everything has changed. It's because I feel that in my spirit. It's because of God. Not because of time. And how can he preach except he be sent by God?
Right, man.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
You got to really, if you really want to change life, you need to go to God.
Amen.
That's right.
You need to go to God. Yes. And then there's nothing wrong with you going to somebody that has that experience of being changed.
Come on.
Amen. And living holy.
Come on.
Come on now. You don't go to nobody that just is worse off than you are.
All right.
They drink more than you drink. They lie more than you. Come on now. But you need to go to somebody that you knew that was in the world.
Come on.
In the world, out there, doing things that were sinful. But now they life.
Yes.
There's a reflection.
Hallelujah.
Of holiness.
Yes.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Somebody say holiness.
Holiness.
Is your life a reflection of holiness?
Yes.
That is something that you ought to ask yourself.
Amen.
Am I reflecting holiness? Because number one, we are the light of the world. We're supposed to be the light of the world.
Amen.
A city that sits on the hill, it cannot be hid.
Come on.
You know, some people call themselves sanctified, but they hide.
Right.
They hide sanctification.
Amen.
So y'all better come on with it. But when you really got it, it's gonna light up. It's gonna light up. Amen. Can you put a light under a bushel and it not, you know, and it not burn?
Come on.
I mean, when you put fire under something's gonna take place there.
Right.
You hear what I'm saying? But being the light of the world, to me, it's a blessing.
Yes, it is.
It's a blessing. To be able to live this life in somebody, and somebody is seeing the life that you live.
Yes.
I know how you used to be. Y'all can't tell me he ain't saved, because I remember when.
Yes.
Y'all better come on. Y'all got that testimony?
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Hey, when people remember when.
Yes.
Amen. When you was a dope addict.
Come on.
They remember when.
Oh, yes, they do.
Amen. When you was out on the streets.
Come on, man.
Using women out in the streets.
Come on.
Oh, y'all better come on with me now. Amen. But God changed you. Oh, what a change in your life.
Yes.
And let me just say this, sinner, that haven't given God, you can be changed.
Oh, yes.
That's right.
You don't have to sit up there and say, oh, I wish I had it. I wish I had it. It's yours.
Amen.
It's yours for the asking. All you have to do is ask God. God, I want to be saved. Will you save me? He ain't going to turn you down because he wants you to be saved.
Yeah.
He would that no man shall perish, but also come what? Unto repentance.
Yes.
And you got to come to God with a repentance heart.
Yes.
Meaning it from your heart.
Yes.
Not just saying it for that moment, because sometimes people say things for that moment.
Right.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There was a time I was sitting up in the bar school saying things at that moment because I felt guilty about certain things. So I was sad. But soon as I finished saying what I said, I went on back to party. I went on back shaking my behind. I went on back drinking my alcohol. But there was a time that I needed to, amen, put this thing in action.
Yeah.
I used to go home, and I tell this testimony, I used to go home in tears because I was raised in holiness, raised in sanctification.
Yes.
I was sanctified at one time, but I backslid.
Come on now.
Changed and turned from God. But God had mercy on me.
Yes, Lord.
Did y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes, Lord.
Could have died in my sin. There were times that I know that, and I felt like I could have died on the highway. I could have died doing this and doing that. But God made death behavior.
Yes,
still, I didn't have sense enough to realize. I did realize, but sense enough to do, amen. God gave me a chance. And taking advantage of that chance, God, you know what? I knew I really wanted to be saved, but I just didn't want to give up those sins. I was having a good, let me tell y'all something. I understand when you out there in the world, you having a good time.
Mm-hmm.
You having fun out there in the world. I ain't going to tell nobody, you know, there are some people that might have been miserable, but everybody ain't miserable out there in the world.
All right.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
I'm just being honest with you. I'm just being true with you. Amen. I was out there having fun.
Come on.
But then after a while, I sit down and I go home and I begin to start reminiscing. And I begin to start feeling sorry within myself. And I said, I know better. I know better. And God, I don't want to change. I just kept saying, praying to God. But I just didn't want to say, God, save me. Well, God, if you save me, God, if you do this, then I live with it. I didn't want to be playing around with God.
Yeah.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I wanted to be, amen. I didn't want God just come in my life or fix things for me and then don't do it.
Come on, man.
Amen. Because you gotta be careful what you promise. God, if you take me out of this, you take me out of that, I'll live with you forever. How many of you all lied to God like that?
Right.
I'm gonna be, you know what, God? I thank you. Sometimes you get so scared, God deliver you from, you know, from diseases, and God delivered you, amen, from being stabbed, and God delivered you from, amen, cancer, and you gave God a promise. God, if you get me up out of this sickness, this death bed, I'll live with you forever.
Come on.
God ain't seen you yet.
Come on now.
You're still in the world. All right. But one day.
One day.
One day, saints. One day, people. I got tired of crying. I got tired of tears coming out. After I done had my fun, now I get home and I feel guilty.
See?
Do you hear what I'm saying? But it was God warring with me. That's what it was. It was the Spirit of God.
Come on, thank God for
the Spirit of God that was warring with me.
Hallelujah.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Because
God could have turned me over, man. He could have turned me over to reprobate because I knew better.
Yeah.
I had the baptism of the Holy Ghost. I used to speak in tongues, but I gave it all up for the world.
Shame on me. Come on now.
But God.
But God. Hallelujah.
You all hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
But God, one day I came to God in sincerity.
Come on now.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
You know, and God didn't make fun of me when I came to him. I'm kind of halfway high.
Come on.
You know, crying and tears and whatnot. Because, you know, that sometimes you feel that remorse. You kind of feel like, I could be doing something better.
Mm-hmm.
I could be serving the Lord. So that remorse, you know, you begin to start feeling sorry. And begin to, God, I know I can do better. God, I want to do better. But it just seems like, you know, I just can't do it. No, you just can't do it by yourself. You can't do it by yourself. You can't do it by yourself. That's why you need help from God.
Hallelujah.
He's a mighty God. He's a great God. He's a Savior. He's a deliverer. He's a heart fixer.
Glory to God. Yes, he is.
I'm telling y'all what I know.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
But one day when I went to God, after I came from the tavern.
Yes.
Went to God. Again, I didn't want to make no problems because I was feeling this thing of remorse and feeling like God, you know. And you know what God told me? God will talk to you.
Oh, yes, he will.
God will talk to you.
Yes, he will.
Oh, yeah, God will talk to you. It'll be real, too.
Come on,
if you wonder where that comes from, it comes from God.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all don't believe God will answer some sinner's prayer.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
He ain't going to answer foolishness now.
Right.
But when you really want to be saved, God will answer my seeking in your shut down. When you gonna be for real?
All right.
That's right.
Amen. That's not my purpose today, but God knows what to do.
Right, sir.
All right. Amen.
Hey.
Amen.
You don't have to be in and out, like I was in and out.
Come on now.
But you know what? God had mercy on me.
See?
And don't think in your heart and in your mind if God saved him and he was in and out. Amen. I can do it until I get ready. It don't work like that. Some people are dead today. And went out only one time. And backslid only one time. He has mercy on whom he will.
Yes, that's the word.
I'm talking to you.
Amen. Come on now.
I'm talking to you.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God is talking to you.
Jesus. Amen.
I'm tired.
My God.
Make up your mind.
Yes.
Don't let it be said. Too late. Somebody to enter into the golden gate.
Yes.
That's why he said, make up your mind.
Yes. Come on.
Don't let it be said. Too late. Because it can be too late.
Yes.
When you ready for God, God ain't ready for you no more.
All right now.
He has mercy.
Amen.
Life is not promised to us, amen, longevity.
No.
Come on. on now.
Amen.
You didn't make yourself. God made you. He formed you into the dust of the earth. He breathed the command, and man became a living soul.
Yes, God.
A living soul.
Somebody.
Yes. Right now. When you gonna take no? When you gonna take no? God said, take no to what I'm saying.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hear my preachers.
Yes.
Hear my teachers. That's preaching you the truth. And not telling you we all sin and I sin and everybody sin. And God knows we can't help but sin. But God can help you with your can't have it.
Yes, yes, he can. Yes. Yes, he can.
The devil will send you people say, all that, you know, but a lot of you know. Stuff and right. You know they talking about you live saved. Can't nobody live saved. Amen. But I beg your pardon. Yeah. I'm living saved and sanctified. I know that God brought me up.
Yeah.
And being compared about was so great a cloud of witnesses.
Yeah.
Hey, I ain't by myself.
Right
now, there's a little hidden right here. Right here. Right. Say, sanctified. Holy Ghost.
Holy.
Five somebody say amen.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.
Some of us been through what you've been through, yes. That you're going through right now. We've been there and done that.
That's right.
Amen. Come
but
on.
God is a deliverer. Somebody say, God is a deliverer.
God is a deliverer.
Hallelujah.
But do you want to be delivered?
Come on. That's the question.
Because he who the Son has set free is free indeed.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, Lord.
When God frees you, you free.
Yes.
Unless you go back into it yourself.
Right.
Because God freed you from sin and take the desire. Amen. But you can go back into it yourself.
Right.
By fooling around with the wrong people.
Come on.
Fooling around with the devil.
Come on.
Oh, y'all better come on with me now.
Come on.
And then try to put the blame on somebody else.
Yes.
It's your fault.
Right.
It's appointed once for man to die.
Yes,
and after
yes.
That, man, amen, there's a judgment.
Yes.
All of us got to stand before the judgment seat of God to give an account of the things that we do in this body.
Yes,
you can't blame nobody.
Nobody.
Amen. Nobody.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
When you stand before God, you can't say the devil made me do it.
See? Come on, man.
You don't have to yield to the devil.
No, you don't.
You don't have to give in to the devil.
No,
amen. Ask God to give you some power.
Yes.
Ask God to give you some strength. Ask God.
Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank
tell
you,
Lord. He will save you.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes,
he will save you right now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right now. He will save you. He will save you. He will save you right now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus, come to Jesus right now. Amen. The opportunity is here.
Yes, it is.
The opportunity is here.
Yes, it is.
What are you waiting on?
Come on.
Yes, come on.
Come on now. There's no such thing as deathbed salvation.
All right.
You might not even get to that point where you have time to say, Lord, forgive me.
Right.
Oh,
right.
Y'all ready to hear me now.
Come on.
It's easy for somebody to say, you know, do you want to be saved? And they on their deathbed.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes they might not even understand what you're saying.
Come on.
Do you need God in your life? Yes. Do you want God to come into your heart? Yes. But where's the fruit? Sometimes we say things because we fear death. But was it real? Y'all better hear me now.
Come on.
Everybody don't get that chance to call on God.
Right.
On their deathbed.
That's right.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
So you can't count on that. God, you know what? When God gets ready for me, then I'll be saved. He ready for you now.
Right. Come on.
Duh. He waiting for you right now. He ready. He's got his arms open wide. What are you talking about when God get ready for me? He ready now.
Right now.
He sent his son. He made it to my hell life. He ready right now.
Right now.
He's standing there right now.
Right now. Hallelujah.
What you
Lord
mean?
Glory to God.
When God get ready.
Come on.
No, you need to turn that around.
See?
I got to get ready.
Yes. Amen.
Get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Don't stop saying I got to get ready. Get ready.
Amen.
Do it.
Do it. Put it in action. scare people.
Right.
No, we're just trying to warn people.
Come on now.
It's not all about trying to scare you into holiness. Because right. when that wear off, amen. But this thing got to be in your heart.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
That's right.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Do you really want, I mean, forget about your friends, your family, but you know, they gonna want to be around me, they gonna want to do this, and they want, God didn't come to bring peace on earth, but a sword.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, amen.
Sometimes because you say you want to be separated from your family, that's because right. they don't even want to have anything to do with you. And some of them call you Holy Roller.
Yep.
But going to heaven, is that worth going, amen, you losing your family because of God? Is that worth going to heaven?
Yes,
that's worth going to heaven. I love my family, but when it comes down to God, God's got to be first.
That's right.
Amen.
Somebody say first.
First.
Is God first? God got to come before you.
That's right.
Oh, my goodness.
Amen.
God's got to come before you. Because it ain't all about me. It's got to be all about God.
Yes.
Right.
Amen?
Right.
Amen. You want to be saved? I want to be saved one day. I want to be saved one day. You don't have to wish. I want to be saved one day. Sometimes people look over and see how God is using the saints, and using the sanctified people, and how God, amen, lay hands and they become delivered. And then he's saying, I want that. I want that. One day I want that. What's wrong with now?
Right.
Amen.
What's, why one day? Today can
Come
be the day.
Right.
Now is the time. Now is the day of salvation. Today, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Don't back up. Do it today.
Today.
You just keep saying tomorrow, tomorrow, later. Amen. But do it today. Today. What you waiting on? What you waiting on? Do what you gonna do when you leave here and your soul and your spirit be in torment. That's where you're going, your spirit and your soul. The body is going to the grave, it's going back to the dust. But that spirit and soul goes to where it's supposed to go.
Amen.
And that's torment first. Then after a while, God's gonna raise that body. Bring that body back, that soul and spirit back into the body. It's gonna come, and it's gonna come so you can be destroyed in the lake of fire.
Come on now.
I'm not just telling you something that you just see on TV.
Come on now.
This ain't no thriller.
Come on.
This ain't no creature. This is something that's real.
Y'all
better hear me now.
Yeah.
This ain't no sci-fi movie.
Come on, sir. Come on.
This is real.
Yes, it is.
And sometimes people make fun of the church.
Yes.
Make fun of the preachers in the church. And make fun of the church folks in the church. But you're going to have to stand before God. You that making all those kind of movies and keeping people from being serious about God.
Come on now.
It ain't going to be as bad as all that. It's going to be worse than what they can put down even in the movies.
Come on now. Amen. Amen.
I'm telling you. But the Bible says they're going to be weeping and gnashing, of teeth.
Yes,
it's going to be so bad you can't even stand. You're going to be hollering and screaming and saying, God, woe is me. Woe is me. Come get me out, but it's too late.
Amen. It's too late.
Come on, y'all.
Come on. Amen.
I can't plead with you. You know, the devil don't want us to preach these kind of
things. No, he don't.
He don't want us reaching out. He don't want me reaching out to you right now. Some of you ready to turn off and go to something else right now. But that could be the last time you have your eyes open.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
And you just shut the door on God.
My God.
Come on now.
My God.
Don't shut the door on God.
All right now.
Don't you shut that door on God.
Come on. Come on now.
You just shut the door on God. People just shut the door on God. God has shut the door on you.
Yes, he will. Oh, yes, he will.
Talk, sir.
Come on.
I got to talk to you.
It's all right. Amen.
Don't play with the church. Don't make fun of the church, folks.
No. Come on.
Like them children. How many children it was?
Yeah. 42
children.
Yes, sir.
Making fun of Elijah.
Yes.
Call him. Go ye up, you bald head. You bald head. He minded his own business.
Right.
Messing
right.
with the man of God.
See?
And God sent a bear to come out.
Come on.
Yes, sir.
And kill him.
Yes, sir.
They were children.
Yes,
right.
They were children. They weren't grown. Right. They were children. But you know what? God knew that they knew better.
Yes, yes, yes.
That's right, Bishop.
Come on.
You mean that's a shame? You mean to tell me God had two bears? To come, God yes. had two bears to come yes. out to kill them, children?
Yes, sir.
You can't say children don't know.
Right.
Some children know.
Yes.
Some of them were raised in holiness.
Come on.
Some of them used to be sanctified yes. at the age of 12, 13.
Yes. yes.
That's right.
And left God.
Come on down.
Right.
That's a shame. Why did God allow that? Why did they do what they did?
Right.
Come on, Bishop.
They knew that was the man of God.
Yes, come on, come on.
Go ye up. And that's what some people are today, evangelists.
Yes.
They making fun of church folks.
Yes, yes.
There
yes.
you go again. There you go. Preaching the same thing. There you go. I'm so sick, and one day you're going to be so sick, and God's going to be sick of you.
Come on now. All right.
Don't play. Don't make fun of church folks.
No. Come on.
When I was growing up in church, I didn't make fun of church folks. I actually tell you the truth, when I was young, I wanted to be just like them.
Come on, say it now.
I tried to shout his ass like them.
Oh, my God.
I shouted his ass, amen. I wanted to be like them.
Yes.
Now I'm really like them.
All right, now.
I'm really shouting his ass now. I'm really speaking tongues now. I'm going to speak in your face now. Hey!
Oh, glory.
Woo! Hallelujah. You gotta put away child and stuff. How you used to act. Some grown folks act just like children.
Yes, they do. Yes,
silly.
They do.
Yes, sir.
Silliness.
Amen.
You don't realize how silly you are with God.
Come on.
Grow up. Be the man that God wants you to be. Yes. Be the woman that God wants you to be. Do y'all hear what I'm saying out there? Do you hear what I'm saying in here?
Come on now.
We are running for our lives.
That's right.
We in God, but we still running for the life. But you know why? Because the devil want to get a hold of us.
Amen.
No, they see they preaching too hard. See, he bringing folks to holiness. Amen. He putting something on their mind. We got to get rid of him.
Come on now.
Hey, but I'm on the Lord's side.
Yes, Lord.
That's what you got to say. I'm on the Lord's side. And I like to be under God's protection.
Yes, amen.
If God before you. Who can be against you?
Come on now.
Even though sometimes people might pray against you.
Yeah.
And pray and say things about you. You know, amen. But I ain't going until God says, I ain't going.
Come on. Say that. Say that.
Because God ain't through with me yet.
No.
God ain't through with me yet.
Amen.
Come on now. God is saving somebody. God is going to every somebody being saved someplace, somewhere. Somebody wanted it right now. Why can't it be you? Don't wait till you get to that moment.
Right, sir.
Because you hear the preaching.
Thank you, Jesus.
You begin to feel guilty.
Right.
I know he's right. I know that pastor's right. I understand you. I've been there. And I just felt like this was the time I was going to do it.
Right.
Well, as soon as I got outside, out of the church, it was me and the world. And that's why the Bible told us to love not the world, neither the things of the world, because the world is not going to let you look at God.
Right.
Can I say that again?
Yes. Amen.
The love of the world is not going to let you look at God and consider God for salvation.
Right.
Because you love the world, and I don't care. It can be more than just simple things in the world. It can be good things in the world that's keeping you from coming to God.
All right. That's right.
Oh, y'all can come
yes,
over
sir.
Here. Who do you love? Who do you love? Who do you love? Come on now. But God,
man.
With his arms stretched out.
Yes.
Come. He's still saying, come.
Yes.
I heard them on the conference line not too long ago this week. Amen. They were calling out. They were calling out for somebody to come.
Yes.
Giving them the invitation. But you know what it is? The devil will make you feel like, I want to do it, but I'm so nervous.
Yeah.
I was just fearful. Because everybody going to be paying attention to me. What do I care? Amen. Everybody paying. You know, if I go up there, everybody going to be looking at me. But let me tell you something. Real saints of God will be happy for you.
Yes.
They will be rejoicing. Yes. But if I can rejoice with them that are being rejoiced.
Come on. Come on.
For such were some of us.
That's right.
Amen.
But now we are sanctified.
Yes.
Now we are justified.
Now. Yes.
Now. Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Yes, sir.
God knows how to change the script, don't
he?
Yes, he does.
God wants somebody to hear this.
Yes.
Working on somebody.
Yes.
Just like the camouflage, they were working on somebody. They just kept saying it, just kept on. You can't never say you never got the invitation.
All right,
that's right, Bishop.
If you lose your life out there in the world, you can't say that God didn't give you the invitation. Because God will play it back in your mind. Remember when the preachers called out to you and they warned you, but you made fun of it. You made light of it.
Come on now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
You made light of it. And then the Bible said, God said, he will mock you when your calamity comes. He will make fun of you. At you.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Come
I'm
on.
It's in the book.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Yes, it is, sir.
He said, I'll laugh at your calamity.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I'll laugh at your calamity.
Come on.
I don't want God laughing at me.
No,
sir.
No.
No, sir.
Amen.
Trust me. I don't even want some people laughing at me.
See?
Unless we're doing it in fun. You know,
come on.
Some crazy things. Sometimes people laugh at you, but it's all in
right.
fun. But when it's come down to serious, don't laugh at me. Tell right. me what I did wrong.
Right. Amen.
So I can get it right.
Come on now.
God ain't laughing at you now. He's telling you now so you can get it right now.
Come on. Come on. Yes.
Get it right now.
Yes.
What you going to do? What you going to do? That's a decision only you can make.
Right.
You can't go to your mama and say, Mama, what did I need to do?
Come on,
she can't make that decision. Daddy, what can I do? What should I do? Husband, what should I do? Amen. That's the decision that you got to make for yourself. Your mama, your daddy, your husband, your uncle. Amen. Come on now. Your third cousin can't make that decision for you. You got to make it for yourself.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
What you going to do now?
Amen.
Just visualize it.
Yes.
You visualize it. Everything else. When you're out in the world, you visualize yourself, amen, having that girl.
Uh-huh.
Come on now. You can see it before the night comes.
Okay.
You done found your thrill. Amen. You done found your thrill. On what that song, Blueberry Hill or something like that. Amen. They didn't visualize it in their mind. Man, I just can't wait. But what about God? Can you visualize yourself being in the presence of God?
Hey.
Y'all better hear me now.
Yeah.
I can visualize it in my mind, in my heart, and in my spirit. Amen. Being before God and hearing God say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. That's what I want God to say.
Yes,
what do you want the Lord to say?
Yeah.
What do you want the Lord to say? Oh, well done, thou good and faithful servant. That's what I want my Savior to say.
Oh, yes.
All of us want God to say, well
done.
Yes. Well done.
But
well
you
done.
Ain't doing well.
Well
done.
All right.
Hallelujah.
He ain't gonna lie to you.
Glory to God.
God is a man that will not lie.
Will not.
Lying is not in his vocabulary.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Come on now. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Come on now. This is the decision that you have to make.
Right.
You can make it right now in your prayer closet.
Yes.
I'm not saying you got to go in the closet, but you know that means you're all to yourself.
Yes. Glory to God.
Come on now.
Yes.
So you know what, y'all? I got to leave you. I got to leave y'all. I got to go. Because I need to talk to God.
Come on.
God. Yes. God, what you talking about, baby? Baby, I need God.
Come on.
Come on. That's what I'm missing. Some of y'all be wondering. What am I missing? Look like every time I do this and I do that, it don't fill the void. It's a void in my life.
Right.
It is God that's left the void in your life.
Come on now.
You trying your best.
Amen.
best to fill that void. Something in there. God is letting you fill that void because he's not letting you feel satisfied with sin.
Amen. Amen. Come on.
What you gonna do with it?
Thank
you, Jesus. And those of you that are even thinking about turning from God, don't even turn from God. Don't even think to turn from the true and living God.
Amen.
What's your problem?
Come on.
What's your problem?
Yes.
After you've tasted of the goodness of Jesus Christ,
yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Yes. You have tasted of his goodness. You have tasted of his mercy. Yes. Now you look at the world.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Bible said, he that looking back,
yes.
Not even fit for the kingdom
yes.
of God. Just looking back at the world, the design of the world. Come on now. You sending yourself to hell.
Amen. Help, holy.
Oh, y'all been in here, God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Woo.
Bless glory
to God. What you going to do? What you going to do? What you going to do?
Hallelujah.
I can't make you be saved.
Come on now.
I ain't God.
No.
I can't give you salvation.
Come on.
I can't deliver you from sin.
Come on.
But I can tell you how to get it.
Come on now.
Tell you how to get it
okay.
And how to receive it.
Amen. Glory to God.
Let him in today.
Amen.
Let him in to stay.
Yes.
Open your heart.
Yes.
And let God come in.
Come on.
That Amen. Means you got to give God all you got. Amen. You got to open up your heart to God, your mind and your spirit. Your soul to God. Open it up to God like you do all this other lustful stuff out there. You need to open your heart to, and it ain't bringing you salvation and deliverance from sin. But a lot of times it's bringing you trouble, heartaches,
yes.
and pain. And I'm not saying that once you get saved, you ain't going to have to go through nothing. You're going to go through some things, but you're going through some things now and you ain't even saved.
Amen. Come on.
But if you got God on your side,
hey.
He will help you
yes.
in the time of need.
Oh, yes.
Oh, he may not come when you want him, but when he do come, he's right on time.
Amen.
That's right.
You know why? Because God wants you to learn of him. He wants you to know that he's not all about saving you, but he can keep you.
Amen.
In the hour of temptation.
Yes, yes, sir.
How many of us know that God can keep us?
Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
We've been saved, some of us been saved 46 years, 45 years, some of us 20 years, some 10 years. It don't make no difference how long you've been saved, as long as you're saved.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying? God ain't only taking people that's been saved 45 years.
No.
Amen. When he come back, somebody's going to be in trouble. I'm looking for the 45 years.
All right.
I ain't reached that yet, God.
Jesus, see.
But God just wants, amen, you know what? You can just get saved and be saved one day and Christ comes. You ready.
Oh yes.
That's right.
Amen.
You are ready for the rapture.
Amen.
You give God your life just for one day. Amen. Now, I ain't telling you to do it just for one day.
Amen.
But what I'm telling you, if Christ came in that one day that you got saved
right.
and you were sincere, you would right. be caught up.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
It's the time. Look. Matter of fact, the devil was on the cross.
Yes, sir.
They were both guilty.
Yes, they were.
And Jesus was living between both of them.
Yes, yeah. was,
one was making fun. Mm-hmm. And the other one said, we deserve it.
That's right.
And with this, within his heart, within his mind, he said, remember me.
Look at that.
When I go, he received Christ
yes,
as the deliverer.
Yes, he did.
But remember me. See, that's all God wants you to do is remember him and repent.
Amen.
Remember me when I go into paradise. And because Jesus was the Savior, and he's the one that can give you eternal life, he said, this day will you be with me in paradise. What? I don't even think he was up there one whole day.
Yes, God.
It doesn't take all 6 days. You know, some things you got to try out
right,
for 6 days yeah. before it work.
Right.
Try it 6 days. By the end it'll work.
Right.
Salvation will work right then.
Right now. Come on.
Deliverance will work right then.
Yes, Lord.
Holiness will work in your life right then.
Thank
yes.
you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I know I'm talking to somebody. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Do you know who God is?
Glory to God. Thank you, Lord.
God knows who you are.
Oh, yes, he does.
God knows you need saving. God knows you need deliverance. Yes, that's why God is giving you a chance. A chance. A chance. A chance. A chance after chance. A chance after chance. When are you going to wake up?
Yes. Amen.
You got to stand and smell the coffee. When you going to wake up? Come on now. You can do it.
Come on.
Saints, we can do it. We can do all things through Christ, which what strengthens us. God gave us the strength to be able to live holy. We couldn't do it on our own. Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
What you gonna do with it? I'm still reaching out to somebody.
Yes. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Don't you know the angels in heaven rejoice with one soul?
One
soul. It ain't gotta be a whole half of the church. Just one soul. You know what? This thing is so exciting. Salvation is so exciting. The Bible says even the angels desire to look into this.
Amen.
The things that that God does for us, they desire. They already up in heaven, but they desire to look into what's to this. Come on now.
Come on. Amen.
It's exciting to me. You know what? Holiness should not be boring.
Come on. Yes, not to me. Amen.
When you start getting bored of coming to church, something wrong. The devil is seeking that. You're being seeking. Whatever you got, being seeked out. Little at a time.
Yes.
I'm bored. I'm tired of going to church. I'm bored. And you can be in the right church.
Mm-hmm.
You're just bored. They say the same thing. Oh, you know, reaching out to folks. We're doing it for your good.
That's right.
Come on now, we're doing it for your good.
Amen.
You know how it makes us feel when we're reaching out to folks and we know that we're reaching out to folks that we know evangelists, and then when they die, we got to walk past their body and look at them and realize in our mind, they could have been saved.
Amen.
That hurts.
Yes, it does.
That hurts the family. Yes, that hurts the preacher because you had a chance.
Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
We ain't going to be playing with your life. We ain't playing with your life. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
We're not playing with your life. But we want everybody. Who don't want nobody to be saved? Anybody?
Right.
Hey, I wish the whole world could be saved.
Amen.
But everybody ain't going to receive God. Everybody going to receive God.
That's right.
Oh, man, that's a lot of malarkey. Because, you know, they've been saying that when my grandfather was preaching back then. And he was a holy man, too. And so, you know, and just because somebody did you wrong that saved, that they sanctified, don't mean people can't be sanctified.
Right.
That was that one person.
Right.
They take one bad experience and they put it all on the holy children, the holy folks. See, I told you it wasn't nothing to these old holy sanctified folks. Because they were supposed to be sanctified. Everybody that said they're sanctified ain't sanctified.
That's right.
Come on now. The Bible says you will know them by their fruit. Right. And even if they were sanctified, they could be overtaken too if they allow the enemy to come in and take, you know. Come on now.
Right.
That's why, saints, can I say something?
Go ahead.
That's why. You don't know who's watching you.
Amen.
If you're going to be saved, be saved.
Yeah.
Be real. Because somebody is looking at you. How do you know that person that's watching you, amen, is you going to be the cause of them coming to Jesus?
Come on.
Then the devil had you acting a fool. And you left God. Now, they don't want God. Because, you know, that kind of, sometimes that hurts people when they see you. They left church and they really believe that sanctification was real. But you know the devil gets into that too.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
The devil gets into that too. He any kind of way he can discourage you from being in church and being in God, he will do it. They call themselves, you know what? You better be careful who you talk about.
That's
They call themselves sanctified and sanctified. Right. If they sanctified, I'm sanctified too. And baptized and filled with the precious Holy Ghost. You don't make fun like that.
Amen.
Oh, y'all better come on now.
Amen.
I'm saying that for a reason too.
Yes, yes.
I can understand when somebody's hypocrite, you saying that.
Yes.
Amen. And you still shouldn't say that though.
Come on.
If they sanctified, I am too. You know you ain't sanctified.
Right, right.
They just like you if they doing the same thing you do.
Right. Amen.
Not saved.
That's it.
But you know you know a real person that's sanctified, holy.
Come on then.
Walking undefiled before God. Yes. If they say they sanctified. And you can't go by their past experience.
No, you can't. No, sir.
I remember me. I remember when he was doing something. You said, remember when? That's what you said, baby. I remember when. Mm-hmm. But what is he doing or she doing now?
Yeah. Amen.
People love the whole, your what is that, your past.
Right.
In your face.
Right. Yes,
but
yes.
God don't hold your past.
No, he doesn't.
Because he said he'll throw it what? In the sea.
Come on.
That's what the sea. Never to remember what you did anymore. From the time you get saved, they ain't gonna even brought up what you used to did. I don't care what, if you were a prostitute.
Come on now, come on. Come
you're not
on.
A prostitute now.
Amen.
You changed now.
Come on now.
So you no more married a prostitute.
See.
Right.
You married a saint of God.
Amen.
The woman of God.
Amen.
The daughter of God.
Yes.
Y'all better come on
Amen.
Now. Oh, what a change.
Yes. Amen.
But people know, yeah, I remember when. How you going to bring somebody else's past up and you ain't even changed?
See?
Somebody don't like me.
Well,
think about it. Mm-hmm. Jesus told the people that were trying to stone that lady because, wasn't she had another man's? She had another woman's? She had another woman's hug, something like that. Mm-hmm. And they were going to stone her. Stone her to death. And they chased her all the way to Jesus. And she ran to Jesus and fell at his feet. And they were saying, we're going to stone him because he was against the, she did against the law. She didn't know, but she was called an adultery. And when you call an adultery, you get stoned.
That was the law.
That was the law.
That's right.
But Jesus stooped down. Yeah. And he began to write. And he stood up and he said, I believe he stood up and he said, them that have no sin, cast the first stone. What you was trying to do was according to the law. But them that have not sinned,
right.
Come on now.
Right.
Look at yourself.
Right.
You just ain't got caught.
Right.
He left that with her.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Neither do I accuse you.
Right.
Go away, but don't sin.
No more.
Amen. He didn't say, well, you know, if you sin again, you know. No, he said, no more. No more.
Amen.
No more. Because then you're going to have to suffer the same thing.
Yes.
You'll be condemned. Mm-hmm. How merciful is our God? How great.
Come on now.
Is our God?
Yes.
Isn't he great?
Yes. Hey, glory to God.
Just speaking the word of God. Neither do I accuse you.
Yes.
But go and sin. When you come before God, God ain't gonna throw it up in your face.
Come on, come on.
What you sinning before me for?
Lord?
That ain't God.
No.
Oh, y'all better.
No, come on, say it now.
He ain't gonna throw it up in your come on, why and never. He ain't gonna throw that up in your face.
No,
he's willing to take all that from you and then tell you, go and sin no more.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say no more.
No more.
No more. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
He didn't deliver us for us to go back into sin.
No, he didn't.
He saved us so we won't have to sin no more.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
What you going to do about it now? Gonna do about it? Are you gonna turn to Jesus? He will save you.
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
Right now.
Amen.
But he's still saying, go and sin
no more.
And then you gotta then he'll tell you, don't hang around the same people. No more.
All right now.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's important too.
That's important.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Oh, y'all better hear me now.
Right,
are you willing? Have a holy life, a sanctified life before God. It means this gotta mean a whole lot to you.
Yes, yes.
You know what? People play it down, but I don't play holiness down.
Come on down.
Even when I was in the churches, but I didn't play it down.
No.
I knew not to make fun of sanctified folks.
Amen.
My mom was sanctified.
Come on.
And she lived the Bible. She didn't even have a husband or a man coming in and out of the house. When God saved her, my dad left because he didn't want no sanctified wife.
Come on.
I'm just telling you like it is. He left. My mama stayed in church. She gave God her life. She had 5 children. We were all young. Some of us were babies. One of them was babies. And he left her because he wanted her to go to the show with him and go to the bar with him. And she said, I can't do that no more because God saved me. God changed me. I got sanctified. And he said, I don't want no woman like that.
All right, then.
That's why I said you can lose some folks.
All right.
But the Bible said you free.
Amen.
Oh, come on now.
Yes, sir.
Mama raised us in holiness and sanctification until she left here.
Amen.
To the day she died. She was my first mother in the church.
Amen.
When we started in 2001.
Yes.
She came over here with me.
Yes.
Now she's in the presence of God.
Yes.
But I've never seen her, amen, bring Uncle So-and-so over. This is your uncle.
What they call
so you laying with my uncle.
See, come on.
They think sometimes kids are so stupid.
Okay.
Yeah, how many uncles you got?
Come on, man.
Y'all better come on with me now.
That's right. Amen.
I remember one time mother came home, and she said this man tried to get all up in her face and whatnot and tried to kiss on her. She put her whole hand in his face.
Come on, man.
And pushed his whole face away from
him. Come on. See?
And he apologized.
Amen.
I'm sorry.
Get away.
Because sometimes men will try you.
Yes, they will. Yes, they will.
You just too pretty, baby. Uh-huh. You know, you just all that you got. Uh-huh. Ooh, and you let it be wasted.
See.
It ain't wasted.
No, it's not. Come on.
Am I talking
to
you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That'll make you think you're wasting your time. You're too young to be in church. You're wasting your time being in church. Pretty as you are, you ought to be showing them legs and them thighs.
Come on now. That's how you talk. Come on.
Baby, because y'all know you my girl. That's the point. I ain't your girl.
Right.
That's it.
I'm God's good. I believe God.
Say that now.
Y'all better hear that.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to be tempted and tried.
Yes, sir.
In the fire.
Yes, sir.
And I ain't going to tell you that you ain't going to feel the pull. The temptation would be a temptation if you wasn't going to feel it.
Amen.
But you got to know what you got to do. You got to do what you got to do. When she put her whole fear in it, her hand in that man's face. She was serious about holding it.
Oh, yes.
She fed us from the time my daddy died to the day she died. She was there for us. My mom fed us and kept us. She didn't need no man for no husband to help her to move on. But the devil said, see, well, baby, you know what? What can you do without a man? I can do better do better without you than I can with you.
Hello.
All right.
Especially if it ain't the will of God.
Right.
All right, sir.
Oh, somebody
come on. Come on.
Same way, woman.
Amen. Yes.
You can do better sometimes without a man than you can with a man.
Come on.
And vice versa.
Yes. Amen.
Don't let nobody make you think, you know, you need a man. Why do I need a man? I did put a man down here to be one, to marry.
Yes.
Not to try him out, you know.
Right.
See whether you compatible. He don't slam, ma'am, thank you, ma'am.
No.
When it comes down to holiness, I'm just telling you like it is.
Man.
Say it.
You don't want to go through that. I don't know what I can do without sex. If you was dead, you would do without it. If you was in the hospital, you could do without it. If you had a disease, you could have.
Right now.
You can do without it.
See.
But all of a sudden, the devil said, you can't do without it. You know you got to get it. You got to take care of that. You can't do without that. People tell you that, too.
Oh, yeah.
You can't do without a man.
Wrong counsel.
Right. Wrong counsel. I wish I know I'm talking to somebody.
All right.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
But now is the time. Now is the day of salvation. To hear today, if you hear God's voice, harden not your heart. What you going to do, young man? I sold my oats. I'm young. I'm still 12 and 13 years. Jesus was saved. He was 12 years old and going about doing his father's business.
Yes, he was. That's right.
When you come to the point of accountability, to know right and wrong, God holds you accountable.
That's right.
Amen.
Don't you know there are young ladies that are getting pregnant at the age of 10? 10 years old, when I was coming up, you didn't hear all the hear things like that. If you heard it, it was like disgusting.
Yes.
Now they let these kids look at everything on TV, all kinds of sex stuff on TV.
You wonder
why they're pregnant. And they got the nerve to get mad at them. Mm-hmm. You did it.
That's right.
Oh, y'all better come on now.
Well,
yes, sir.
I'm still, God still changed the script. Gonna do. But did you know you can be an example to your children?
Yes, Lord.
Just like my mom was an example, she worked for her money.
Yes.
Come on now, we didn't have everything that she wanted us to have, but we had most things. We ate, we had clothes on our back, we were warm, we was in the projects, but we still had a place to live. You know what the devil led Jesus up to be tempted by him? Don't you know he'll lead you into temptation? But it's to let us know, even though he was Jesus, he was even tempted. But he didn't sin.
No, he didn't.
And then when he had, look at this, when he took him up into the mount and he began to show him the kingdom of this world, he said, all this will I give you if you just serve me. See, the devil make promises. Baby, you can end up being my woman. You'll have everything.
Come on.
You would have no need for anything. Matter of fact, what you want now?
Come on.
I'll buy you the best anything. See, that's why some women, I hate to say this, don't be silly.
Amen.
I'm really begging you, don't be silly.
Amen.
Because some of these men that be off of you, and some of you probably ain't got a dime to
be. See?
And then some of them might have money. But you mean to tell me you're willing to go to hell for? What's worth going to hell for? What you gonna do when you die? You can't take that money and cruise to hell. Come on now.
None of it.
None of them. You can't take it with you when you in that casket. It's just you.
That's right. That's it. All by yourself.
I don't care what he promised. He done stood up there and told you all those lies, what he can do.
Yes.
And he done told five other girls down the street the same thing.
You better
say
that. You better say it. Amen. Amen.
He used to have a saying years ago. Heaven must miss you, something like that, you know, because
must be missing an angel.
Yeah, man. Heaven must be missing an angel, but baby, people can say anything. I used to say sign their neck to get what they want. Then after they get what they want, they don't even want to have nothing to do with you.
See, come on.
Tell their friend. Don't you know?
Right.
Don't tell. They're going to tell their friend, man. I had that.
Amen.
Man, some of them say she wasn't nothing. Could have did better. Come on now.
Amen.
And you think they? I'm just telling you what's real.
Amen.
You think that man loves you? Oh man, he told me he'll give me everything I want, everything I need. Is that worth going to hell for?
Come on.
You might not even be enjoying it. Get this for me, somebody.
Amen.
Living on clothes. That rich man. That dress. Very sumptuous.
Yes.
Every day.
Yes. Amen.
Again, to boast. Then he said what he's going to do.
Amen.
That's why you got to be careful in making plans.
Yes. Yes.
Guided in your plans.
Amen.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
If God is not in your plans, it ain't going to work out.
Amen.
Or it might work out, but it might not be to your favor.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
You got that?
Yes, sir.
Read that for me.
Luke 16 and 19.
That just came to me. Luke 16 and what?
19.
And I want you to listen to me real good. Those of you that got some money in your pocket. Money in the bank. Feel like you got it made. And here you are, retired now. And you got plans.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with having plans,
right,
as long as your plans are right and righteous.
Amen.
And still got God included.
Amen.
In it.
Right, sir.
Or, I guess I got to talk to somebody.
All right.
But I want you to hear this. I want you to hear what I'm saying. And take note of what I'm saying. And this is real. This was written by holy men. And they were inspired by God.
Amen.
Not just any man, but the men of God.
Yes.
You can take it for what it's worth. Or not. Read that, man. Read it out.
Amen. Luke 16:19.
What did it say?
There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fed sumptuously every day.
There was a rich man that dressed very sumptuously. Did it say every day?
Every day.
Every day.
Oh, he had it going on every day.
Every day.
Every day he was dressed.
Come on.
Sharp.
Yeah.
Very sumptuously. Hey.
Every day.
You could tell he was rich.
See.
Go ahead, take your time now.
And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus.
Go back some more.
There was a certain rich man,
yeah,
which was clothed in purple and fine linen,
uh-huh,
and fared sumptuously every day.
Every day he made sure he was sharp. Uh-huh.
And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus.
Certain beggar named Lazarus. He was a beggar. I can imagine being a beggar. He didn't look like the rich man.
Oh, no.
He wasn't dressed fair sumptuously every day. He was a beggar.
Amen. Amen.
He had to go to people for help.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
He had his hands out looking for arms to be helped. Oh, y'all been coming with
Amen.
That.
Amen.
I'm talking about the beggar man.
Yes.
Go ahead.
And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus.
Lazarus.
Which was laid at his gate full of sores.
Full of sores.
And desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table.
He wanted, just give me some crumbs. I don't care what you give me. Even if it's just crumbs. And see, back there in those days, the Israelites supposed to feed people that were, didn't have it. Mm-hmm. That was part of the law. If you had it, you were supposed to share it with them. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's right.
That was according to the law. Yes, God sir. Made sure yes, that if any of your brothers among you were poor, you either had to take them in or feed them. Oh, y'all better hear me now.
Yes, sir.
Now he's every man for himself. Go ahead, baby.
Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores.
Moreover, while he was sitting there, the dogs didn't even respect him. They came and licked his sword. Go ahead.
And it came to pass that the beggar died.
He died. He died like that, y'all. Did y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
He died without being rich. He died without being fed. We come to a point. Go ahead.
And was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom.
Oh, this poor man. They didn't dress very sumptuously every day. Didn't even get any of the crumbs from the rich man's table. Was carried, y'all hear this?
Come on.
Away by who?
The angels.
The angels.
Amen.
Came and got him. Come on, and brought him to the bosom of who?
Abraham.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
This is real. Go ahead.
The rich man also died and was buried, and in hell he lifted up his eyes.
The rich man, the one that dressed fair sumptuously every day, and did not give the beggar any crumbs from the fall from his table, didn't dress him up, didn't take him in, he also died. His riches didn't keep him from dying.
Come on, say that.
Dressing fair sumptuously didn't keep him from dying. Appointed once for man to die.
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me?
Yes.
The rich man. Read that again. Rich man died.
Amen. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom.
Uh-huh.
The rich man also died and was buried.
And was buried. Mm-hmm. They said that by Abraham. Come get you.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder why. God allowed Abraham to come and get, an angel to come and get the poor man, and didn't let an angel come and get the rich man. It had to be something to that. Because riches don't get you into heaven.
Come on.
That's right.
Come on now.
Being poor don't get you into heaven either.
No.
But living right gets you to heaven.
Right.
Keeping the law of God gets you into heaven.
That's right.
Amen.
We can't even put poor people in heaven. It's the life that they still live.
That's right.
Well, y'all come on with me now. But it was something about that poor man. He still kept the law.
Yes, amen.
Of God.
Yes, he did.
Well, y'all better hear me now.
That's right.
You can be poor and still keep the law of God and go to heaven poor.
Make it. Yes, yes, sir.
Amen.
Then you get riches.
That's right.
Yes.
Go ahead, Amanda.
And in hell, he lifted up his eyes.
The rich man went to hell.
Yes.
He didn't go nowhere. He didn't even touch heaven.
No, he didn't.
He didn't even touch paradise.
No, sir.
Y'all better hear what I'm saying.
Amen.
Don't count on your money and your car and whatnot to get you in heaven. You can't take it with you. I told you you couldn't take it with you. The rich man also died. Go ahead, Ben. Come on.
Amen. Amen. And lift up his eyes, being in torment.
In torment, y'all, I'm telling you, in torment. He wasn't having a good time down there.
No, sir.
He wasn't having a party. Party. No, he wasn't down there partying. Wasn't nobody down there partying.
Come on now.
that was in torment. Go ahead.
And seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom.
This is what gets me. Because during that time, paradise was down. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Hades. And hell was down. But there was a thought, we go there. But there was a God fix. And all those that kept the law of God went to paradise.
Yes, sir.
And all those that did not keep the law of God and was committing things that was against God's law was in what? Torment. But come on now. Come on, go ahead.
And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me.
Oh, it's his turn now. Mm-hmm. When the beggar man was sitting there and he was asking for alms and asking for crumbs, he didn't have any mercy.
No.
It's amazing how, you know, when people got it, they don't have no mercy.
Right.
But then when they really need help from you, they want mercy.
Right.
They didn't help them. They didn't help them. He didn't help the poor man.
Amen.
Oh, y'all better come on with me.
Come on.
But when he looked across and saw that the poor man, the beggar man, was over in the bosom of Abraham, he saw that he was in a better place than where he was. Oh, y'all better come on with me now. So let me tell you all that's sanctified. And you might not have much, but you got more than what a rich man has if he's not saved.
Man.
That's right.
You got more. Because as long as you live saved, you got eternal life. And God is going to take care of you. You ain't got to worry about taking care of you. You ain't got to worry about the world taking care of you. God will open up doors. He'll supply your every need according to his riches and glory. But you got to want salvation too. Go back to that bigger man and look across.
Amen. And in hell he lift up his eyes. Mm-hmm. Being in torment. And seeth Abraham afar off. Lazarus in his bosom.
And Lazarus in his bosom. That's amazing. That's torment all together.
Yes, it is.
Just to see that. What? What are you doing over there?
Right.
And I'm over here. Okay. Go ahead, Matthew.
And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me.
Have mercy. Now he want mercy. Oh, come on now. He in hell now. But now he want mercy. He seen that Lazarus had mercy. Amen?
Amen.
God had mercy. Because he was living right.
Amen.
But he looked over there. Said, have mercy on me. Go ahead.
And send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame.
Go over here. He has the nerve. The very person that he turned down, didn't feed, didn't dress. See, tell y'all something, even in life, you got to be careful who you mistreat. Because the very person you mistreat might have to be there for you when you need it. Because God sometimes will set it up like that. Just to let you see, you had treasure, you had all this, but you didn't have mercy on nobody, you didn't have kindness toward nobody. Now you need their help.
Right.
Come on with me now. God will bring you to this place just like he's at that place. I'll be here. He didn't even call for nobody else over there. He recognized Lazarus.
Amen.
Oh my God. If you could just send Lazarus over, he didn't even ask Lazarus when he come over. He asked Abraham, send him over. Go ahead.
But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receivest thy good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things. But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented.
Don't you know God will bring it to you, remember?
Come on.
God will throw it up in your face. That's why I said God said he will mark you When your calamity come, his calamity was there. And he put it to his remembrance. Remember when he was, come on now. And he came to you and you didn't have mercy.
Come on.
Now you want me to send him over?
Ain't gonna happen.
I wonder what he has said. See? Are you kidding? You got to be kidding me. Are you kidding me? Yeah, baby, please.
Amen.
I like that one too. Have you lost your mind?
Yes. Amen.
When it was your turn, you couldn't do it. But now you over there, come on now, something wrong with him. Yeah, it was something wrong with him. He was in torment.
Amen.
Read that again, Evangel. I still get more out of it. Go ahead.
That's all right. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receivest thy good things.
You had everything you needed and wanted.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And likewise, Lazarus, evil things.
Remember, come on now. Remember?
But now, he is comforted.
He's comforted.
And thou art tormented.
Now you tormented.
Amen.
Now, that is important now, right?
See.
Y'all better come on with me.
Amen. Now.
Sometimes the very people that you mistreat, you would have to go to them.
Come on, you better say that.
And say you sorry.
You better say that.
You up now.
Uh-huh.
But you're going to need somebody if you go
all
out.
All right now.
Come on, man.
Amen. And besides all this.
Besides that.
Between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed.
Even if I could, or we even want to permit him to do it.
Come on.
It's not permissible.
Not possible. Come on,
because God fixed it like
yes,
that.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. Amen.
So that you won't come over here.
See.
Because I know they didn't want to go over there. They were torment. So I just couldn't see them wanting to go over there. Ooh, I want to go to torment.
I know. Come on.
Is that all right?
Yes,
I don't see nobody. You see somebody on fire. You don't want to go over there. No. Let them come over here. I'm good. But go ahead.
Amen. And besides all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf.
Great gulf. God fixed it like that.
Yes.
That's when paradise was down.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
So that they which would pass from hence to you cannot.
You can't come.
Neither can they pass to us that would come from thence.
Come on now.
Then he said, I pray thee therefore,
I pray. You beg him.
That thou wouldest send him to my father's house.
Please. If you're not going to do it for me. You see, when he was like, he wasn't going to find hope and mercy.
Right.
But I beg of you. He started pleading for his kid, folks. Go ahead.
For I have five brethren.
I have five.
That he may testify unto them.
Uh-huh.
Lest they also come into this place of torment.
Go back and tell them.
Yeah.
Warn them. So they don't have to come here.
Glory to God.
Don't you know there's some people praying in hell?
Oh, yeah.
In torment?
Yes, come on.
God, if you just... Come on now. I'm talking to somebody. Go ahead.
Abraham saith unto him.
Yeah.
They have Moses and the prophets.
They got Moses and the prophets. They up there.
Let them hear them.
Hear them. God sent prophets in the land.
Amen.
God sent preachers in the land.
Come on.
So why you want me to sit here? If you're going to hear somebody, hear the man of God that's up there.
Already. Come on. Jesus. Hallelujah.
You're going to pick who you
Amen.
Want.
Amen. Amen.
What make you think they're going to believe him?
Right.
I just came from paradise. And I'm talking to his brother.
See?
Now they gonna think he crazy. Your brother, I just saw your brother. Your brother said, he ain't gonna come back. And he said, now what y'all see that? Come on, for real, what you? Somebody came back, you know what? I saw your brother in the torment. He told me to say, first he told me to say hello. And then he said, I'm just messing with y'all. He said, it's hell down here, so you know, don't come here. might sound a little funny, but I'm serious.
Yeah, I think so.
He wanted to get out of there. If I can't get out, warn him. Amen?
Come on.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
And he said, nay, Father Abraham.
Nay.
But if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent.
I told you. If he had came back, they wouldn't have believed.
See? They would repent.
Man, you crazy.
Come on.
We know good well you went down in no paradise and you didn't see my brother. They wouldn't have received it.
Come on.
Because their heart would have been hardened. But what? If they didn't hear him.
And he said unto him, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead.
See that?
Amen.
They're not going to hear the one that rose from the dead.
Come on.
Here we are live and trying to warn you and tell you, amen, about, you know, being saved and going to hell.
Yes.
And you won't believe us.
Come on now.
But you want somebody, and anybody been to hell?
Right.
If somebody came from hell, would you believe that?
Right.
Uh-oh.
Think it's faith. Come on.
Anybody ever been to hell? Yeah. So a lot of people in hell. Ain't nobody been in hell and come out.
Come on.
Once you get in hell and torment,
that's it.
You dead.
That's it. Amen.
Eternally.
Amen.
Minister, this is a message today.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
If you can't believe the men of God,
come on,
and the women of God, and the saints, I'm talking about real women, real men of God, real saints, not somebody that's just, you know, after your money.
Right.
And after membership. And how large they can have their church. But really concerned about your soul.
Yes.
Hear ye him. How can you hear without a preacher? And how can he preach unless he be sent by who?
God.
That's what you got to look at.
Yeah.
People always want you to prove. Is there really a God? Is there really a God? I know I hear that they say there is a God. Is there really a God?
Come on.
Think about it. Who created you? Some people don't even believe God created them.
Amen.
The devil can change that. Scientifically.
Amen.
They can change that. And he put it in the schools and have it. Teaching it to the children where they can't believe. They just want to discredit God, period. Don't want to give God.
Amen.
What is that? His
credit.
Yes, yes.
That the world was because of God speaking. And when he said, let there be, it became. Think about it. Think about it. Where? Will you spend?
Yeah.
Where will you spend eternity? Where will you spend eternity? Will it be in heaven above? Or will you be lost in hell without God's love? Where will you be? Where will you be eternity? Where will you be eternity? Where will you spend eternity? Will it be in heaven? Or lost in hell without God's love? Where will you spend eternity? I wrote that.
Amen.
Where will you spend? God gave that to me years ago. Where will you spend eternity? Where will you spend eternity?
about
holy.
It. Ooh, I feel that in my spirit. Jesus, gracious Father, right now, the word has gone forth.
Ooh, yay. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes, oh. Ooh, my God, yes. My God.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Touch somebody's heart.
Oh, hallelujah.
Touch somebody's mind.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Touch them right now.
Yes,
oh,
God. Hallelujah.
Give them to realize.
Yes, Lord.
They get to spend their life either in hell.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Or in heaven above.
Yay.
Glory, glory.
The choice is theirs now.
Hallelujah.
Right now, God.
Touch them, God.
Ask me that you touch somebody. Some boy, some girl, some man, some woman.
Thank you, Jesus.
That will receive you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Through this message.
Yay. Hallelujah.
We pray, God. You can take away every sin. You can take every desire.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
It's your will that no man should perish, but that all shall come to repentance. Where will you spend eternity? Where will you spend eternity? Will it be in heaven above or lost in hell without God's love? Where will you spend? Where will you spend? God bless. God bless.
God bless.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, you got a good